Amazon Bedrock's been out for a few weeks now, and I'm answering your questions that you have getting started with the service. If you're not familiar with Amazon Bedrock, then it's a collection of foundation models, generative AI foundation models that you can use to simply build in generative capabilities into your applications. Hello, my name's Mike Chambers, and I'm a developer advocate for Amazon Web Services, working as a specialist in generative AI. And in this video, we're answering the question, what is a token? Now, this is an important thing for us when we're looking at Amazon Bedrock, because tokens are actually the basis for how on-demand pricing works. So we charge for the tokens going into the model and the tokens coming out of the model. So having an understanding of what a token is kind of important. All right, let's jump into the Bedrock console and take a look. If I go to the documentation on the side here and choose base models, then I can come down and choose a particular model. And if we scroll down here, you can click on pricing details here. You'll get taken off to a page which will talk about the pricing for the different regions, for the different models, and it'll be talking about this on a token basis. So, tokens. Let me jump into a demo here that I've got. This demo is running on my local machine, and I'm using the open source Falcon model to do this, which comes with a tokenizer that I can just use and play around with. So the tokenizer takes the input text, so the prompt that we send to the large language model, and breaks it up into little pieces, and it applies a number to each of those pieces, which it sends into the model, because ultimately, the large language model is a machine learning model, and machine learning models use numbers, not words. So part of the process here is breaking the words down into numbers. Now, let's take a look at how words are broken into numbers and how words are broken up into those tokens. In this demo here, we can see the text, hello world. And underneath that, we can see how the Falcon tokenizer would convert that into tokens. And so hello is one token, and then world is another token. And now that little G at the beginning of world basically means that there was a space before world. So we can kind of ignore that, but we've got hello and world, two different tokens. So that all makes sense. So a word is a token. Well, it's not quite that simple. Let's change this a little bit and say hello, comma, world, exclamation mark. Now press enter on that. And now you can see that that's actually been broken up into four tokens. So hello and world are still tokens, but we've also got the comma and we've got the exclamation mark. So words and punctuation, they're all tokens. Well, kind of, but not quite that simple either. Sometimes if we have a more complex word or a word which is made up out of subwords, then those words could be broken up into multiple tokens. Let me show you. So if I say Amazon Bedrock is awesome, exclamation mark, then you'll see this is actually broken up into Amazon, which is a token, and then bed, and then rock, because they are essentially words in their own right. And then is, and then AW and some. Why is that? Well, it's because I spelt awesome incorrectly. And so it's trying to figure out how this might work. And so it's broken it up into two other tokens. Let's just correct the spelling of that and run it again. Awesome actually is a token in its own right. But that's an important point. You see how this works. It will break it up as the way that the tokenizer was designed. And so this is an important point. If we go back to Amazon Bedrock for a second, we have models from a number of different providers. So if we go to the providers list here, we've got AI21 Labs, Amazon, Anthropic, Cohere, and Stable Diffusion, or Stability AI. Now these text large language model providers, so AI21 Labs and Amazon, Anthropic, and Cohere, each may use a different tokenizer for their model. So how can we understand the relationship between our input prompt and the token count? And the way we can do that is by looking at the token counts inside of the AWS console. So let's go to the text playground for a moment. And I'm going to go and select a model. I'm going to select AI21 Labs and whichever model. Let's choose the Jurassic 2 Ultra. And let me go back to my tokens here and take this example and put this into here. And I'm just going to send this as a prompt. Now, it's not a great prompt, right? The model really isn't going to know what to do with this. But we can see from this how many tokens have been consumed by the model. So let's go down and click Run. And I'm not going to focus on what the output is here. I'm going to go to CloudWatch. So let's go to CloudWatch in the console. I'm going to open that into another tab. Let's go over here. And we can look at the CloudWatch metrics for this particular model. So if I go to metrics on the side here, go to all metrics, scroll down. I've got a bunch of different metrics that I can get access to, but Bedrock is one of them. And then from there, I'm just dealing a little bit here with how zoomed in I am on this screen. Let me zoom out just a tiny bit. Okay, so we've got by model ID. And in there, we've got AI21 and then whichever model we used. What model did we use? I need to go back and check. So it was a Jurassic 2 Ultra. So if I look here, so we've got Jurassic 2 Ultra. We've got the input token count, the number of invocations, the invocation latency, and all these types of things. So I can go ahead and look at the input token count. So let's enable that. And we can start to see these metrics coming out. Now, we need to give it just a couple of minutes for those metrics to flow through into CloudWatch metrics. And after we've refreshed just a couple of times, we've got that little spot that's come in here. And it says input token count is 5. So for the input that I put into that model, which is Amazon Bedrock is awesome, exclamation mark, the token count was 5. Now that's a very small number of tokens, but if you're working on a project and you're putting different kinds of prompts in or experimenting with different types of prompts, then you can use CloudWatch metrics here to keep an eye on your input tokens and understand the relationship between the prompts you have and the number of tokens that that will generate. Now, whilst we're looking at CloudWatch, let's also take a look at how we can log the invocations that we make into Amazon Bedrock. So if I go back over to the side here and go to log groups, something I can do is I can create a log group, and I'm going to call this my Bedrock log group. And then I'm going to type in Bedrock log group. And I'll say that that can never expire. Let's just create a very, very simple one for now. Click create. And now we can start to push these Bedrock logs into this particular log group. So let's do that. Let's go back to Bedrock. Over on the left-hand side, if I scroll down towards the bottom, past model access, which is where you go to enable all the models that you want to have access to, we're going to click settings. And in here, let's just go into there, we can click on model invocation logging. And we've got some choices here about where we want to log. So basically, everything that we pass in and get out of the Bedrock service, the Amazon Bedrock service, we can store in S3 or in CloudWatch logs or in both S3 and CloudWatch logs. So for now, I'm just going to put this into CloudWatch logs. It's going to say which log group name do we want to use. So I'm going to paste in the log group name that we just created. I will say to create a new role in order to be able to do that. So this is an IAM role. So this is our Bedrock logging role. So that'll be created with the necessary permissions to do this. And then I'm just going to go to the bottom and click Save Settings. Now with that saved, now when we make a call to our model, to the foundation models, those calls and responses will get logged back into CloudWatch logs. So that's been saved successfully. Let's go back to the text playground. Let's go back to AI21 Labs, and we can say in here, hello, I am doing a logging test. What would you like to log today? So let's scroll down here and press run. Again, I don't really mind what the model comes back to from that. It's doing its best. I've put in a very weird prompt there. Let's go back to CloudWatch. Let's go back to now the log groups, and I can navigate into Bedrock log group that I created before. And in here, we should see, there we go, model invocations. And inside of there, now we can start to see that the data is flowing through. So let's have a open up of this. Here we go. This is the logging information. So it says, hello, I'm doing a logging test. What would you like to log today? And if we scroll down, And so there's the actual text generation itself. You can log anything that interests you. And I'm sorry, AI 21 Labs Jurassic 2, I was asking you a very awkward question, but that is how you can use CloudWatch to both look at the metrics for the Bedrock invocations that you're making and looking at those token breakdowns. And it's also how you can actually log all of the invocations that you're making, so both the prompt and actually the response that you get back from the model as well. I hope that's been useful and it's given you a sense of what tokens are and how you can get some visibility of those tokens inside of the Amazon Bedrock service. If you've got any questions about Amazon Bedrock, then please do drop them in the comments below this video. Subscribe to this channel so you can see more videos like this. And also head over to community.aws. This is a community site all about AWS and all for you. If you go to the menu here and go to Generative AI, then you get to the generative AI space where we have articles not just about Bedrock and not just about SageMaker Jumpstart, but the technology too, and how you can get the best out of this amazing technology inside of your projects and your code. So until the next time, don't forget to press like if you like this video, and I shall see you in the next video.